We want to solve the given exponential equations. Our first equation, we have 5 raised to the power of x equals 78. Since we cannot write 78 as 5 raised to some power, we will have to use logarithms to solve this equation. And because we'll be using the calculator, we're going to use either natural log or common log. In general, to solve an exponential equation, when there's one exponential part, we isolate the exponential part and then take the log of both sides of the equation to solve for x. Notice 5 to the power of x is already isolated on the left side of the equation. So for this example, we'll take the natural log of both sides of the equation. So we'd have the natural log of 5 raised to the power of x equals the natural log of 78. Remember, our goal is to solve for x, so we can apply the power property of logarithms here and move this exponent of x to the front so it becomes the coefficient. So now we have x times natural log 5 equals natural log 78. And now to solve for x, we just need to divide both sides of the equation by natural log 5. This simplifies to 1, so we have x equals this quotient, which we will have to round. So now let's go to the calculator. And we'll just type in natural log 78 divided by natural log 5. And it's typical to round to 4 decimal places. So if we round to 4 decimal places, this would be 2.7070. And we should check our solution. So if x is approximately 2.7070, that means 5 raised to the power of 2.7070 should be approximately equal to 78. So let's go ahead and check this. Notice how it is almost 78. It's a little bit larger than 78 because we did round up, but this does verify our solution. Let's take a look at our second example. Here we have 10 raised to the power of negative 2x equals 2/3. The exponential part is already isolated on the left side of the equation. So now we'll take either the common log or natural log of both sides of the equation. And because here we have base 10, I'm going to take the common log of both sides. So we'll have the log of 10 raised to the power of negative 2x equals log 2/3. And now we can apply the power property of logarithms to move this exponent of negative 2x to the front. So we'd have negative 2x times log 10 equals log 2/3. Now the reason I wanted to use common log on this example was because the common log of 10 is equal to 1, so we could just drop this, but I'm going to go ahead and leave it in just in case we didn't recognize that. So now to solve for x, we'd have to divide both sides of the equation by negative 2 log 10. Notice on the left side, negative 2 over negative 2 simplifies to 1, as well as log 10 over log 10. So x is going to be equal to this quotient here, which we will have to round again. So let's go back to the calculator. And now we're using the common log, so we'll press log 2/3 for the numerator, 2 divided by 3, divided by, we need an open parenthesis for the entire denominator, negative 2, of course log 10 is 1, but I'll go ahead and type it in. So we have a closed parenthesis for the log and for the denominator, and enter. So x is approximately 0.0880. And to check this, this means that 10 raised to the power of negative 2 times 0.0880 should be approximately equal to 2/3. And 2/3 as a decimal is equal to 0.6 repeating. So let's go ahead and verify this. And as you can see, it's very close to 2/3. So our answer is correct. Okay, we'll take a look at some more examples in the next video.